falling.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Today is the weekend of the BikeMS. It's our 24th annual BikeMS in New Bern, North Carolina, and I'm Jeff First, the chapter president. This is Kendall. You want to introduce yourself?
Yep, I'm Kendall Bell. This is my first BikeMS event. I'm the South Carolina Development Coordinator, so I primarily work with WalkMS and Challenge Walk, so this is a great experience to see all these cyclists come together. 2,000 cyclists.
Yeah, 2,000 plus, and we're looking forward to a great weekend, and thanks to Gary being here with a communications piece, we're hoping to have a great weekend.
So what's our job?
Our job is to make sure everybody is connected and make sure it's a safe ride that handles all the communication pieces, that everything is orderly, organized, and in case there's any emergencies, we do the best way we can do it and most effective way we can do it.
So it's like good luck with that.
Yeah.
and you are learning how?
I'm learning by firsthand experience in the best vehicle I hear on route. So I am observing from the best.
Rest stop 5, Dave, K4, DJW. Rest stop 6, Pete, KA4, SXX.
This is rest stop 6, KA4, SXX.
Good signal, Pete. Rest stop 7, W4, XMT.
Okay. I'm in Denby, and I'm doing the BikeMS medical support and ham operations.
What does that entail? What do you have to do?
Follow the cycles if they fall, get injured in any way, render them first aid.
In the 100 miles today and 100 miles tomorrow, how many times might you actually have something to do?
Hopefully none, but probably maybe 4 or 5 times.
And what kind of things do you run into?
Anything from just falling, abrasions, to people having chest pain, shortness of breath.
How are you equipped here?
I have an AED, oxygen, complete first aid kit, and a foam.
And a ham radio.
And a ham radio.
And you're on a motorcycle.
That's exactly right.
How much of this do you do every year?
We do about 8 nonprofit events all over the state. And I do MS every year.
Okay, what's your call sign?
KI4ZXW.
All right, how did you get into doing this?
I worked with a helicopter for 14 years on a helicopter with East Care at Pitt County Memorial Hospital. And I've been a paramedic most all of my adult life.
Are you retired?
No.
What do you do full-time?
I'm still a nurse paramedic.
So this busman's holiday.
Yeah. No time off here.
I see it says you're Unit 3. So who's Unit 1 and 2?
Well, we have 5 motorcycles. And this is the third one we bought.
So this is a group?
Yeah.
Who else is involved?
Dr. Bill Price, myself, we're the core of the group, and then we pick up people that are motorcycle riders, ham operators, and paramedics, and we're PAs. So we purchase all this ourselves. All this belongs to us.
All right, so you're the rest stop guy here.
I'm the rest stop.
And anything happening?
No, it's been great. Everybody's been doing great. A couple of bruises, ibuprofen, but that's about it.
It looks pretty busy here.
It is. It is. It's been great. It's amazing when you see the bikes coming down the road. Just a massive wave moving towards you.
How often do you do this? How long have you been doing it?
4 or 5 years.
And do you enjoy the activity?
Oh, yeah. It's fun. Gets out and, you know, you can do something for somebody.
And you get to play with your radio.
Yes.
A little bit. Repeater seems pretty busy.
Oh, it is. All the hams are getting on it and using it very, very fully today.
What's your radio?
EmComm. And I got the Yaesu in the car in case this one doesn't reach.
Go light.
So you were looking for a sag?
Yes, sir.
And it looks like you found one.
Yep.
What's the problem?
A couple people slowed up and ended up in the back. Just hit my brother and laid it down.
Okay,
back of my shifter.
Oh, okay. So you weren't injured, just
nope.
Mechanical difficulty and can't ride anymore.
Yes, sir.
So you're gonna get a ride.
Get a ride back.
Not making you happy about that, I don't suppose.
Not at all, but we rode here yesterday, so kind of happy.
When you approached me, you had a problem. You didn't know how to find a sag.
Nope.
So how did it work? What did you do?
I just found a volunteer. You guys seem to, you know, call a couple people, take care of the situation, so.
And that would be him.
You ready?
Yes, sir.
I'm Sag 3, and this is Wally. KJ4, UKV.
And you were just asking, does anybody else need a ride? How do you know? How would you find out?
We need to go over to the captains here and find out if there's anybody else been reported.
So we could use like a bus stop or something where everybody gathers, it seems like.
We could, yeah. That'd be a good idea.
Okay.
A big flag that says, if you want to ride, you come over here to this flag.
That'd be nice. Gemini, copy, Sag 9, go ahead. Dock 1, be advised that the ambulance is at rest stop 2 as we speak. Are you at rest stop 2? Negative. I just left there heading for rest stop 4. Okay. Attention on that. Do I have a ham radio operator at rest stop 2 that can talk to me right now?
This is Sag 8 at rest stop 2.
Okay. Immediately contact the rest stop captain. We have a volunteer that possibly has a medical emergency that fainted. I got a doctor en route, but while the doctor's en route, I need some confirmation on what's going on.
All right, tell me who you are, call sign.
Brian Young, KA9QJT.
Tell me about your job. What do you do?
I'm sagging bicyclists today and taking care of communications out on the route.
And how's it going today?
It's so far so good. First rider brought in at the moment. So.
How do you find riders? How do you come across them?
Well, we usually keep an eye out for them on the edge of the road, and if they give us a thumbs up, if they're good to go, maybe just a flat tire, they're fixing themselves. Thumbs down if they got something more serious and they want to be picked up.
All right. And how much business do you get in a typical, is there a typical event?
I've been doing this for about 10 years, and I think 2 to 3 sags a day on Saturday and about the same on Sunday every year.
What does this do for you? Not very many hams do this. Why do you do it?
It's practice, right? It's just practice to get out and use the radios in a different environment, and it beats sitting at home playing on the radio.
Okay. Show me your communication system.
Oh, all right. Well, I'm carrying a Yaesu VX7R as a handy talkie just for when I get out of the vehicle. And in the vehicle, got an IC 2720 dual band, got a couple of the GPS's, and a IC703 10-watt HF radio in the bottom there.
Don't use any HF though.
Nope, not for today. In fact, I don't even have the antenna on the truck, so.
They should follow existing instructions as far as if they're at 6 or 7, just keep doing what they are doing. There are only 15 riders approximately that we're talking about as far as rest stop 5 is concerned.
What do you know is going on?
We've been pulled off the course because the weather is dangerous.
So I suppose nobody's particularly happy about this turn of events.
No, but we'd rather be safe.
But
we're all about safety.
Yeah, no, definitely.
We're fine.
We're fine.
We're fine.
Fine, just fine. Leave us alone.
No, we're fine.
What is the location that you're talking about?
Unfortunately, we've had to close the course. Because of thunderstorms that have come through already and what we're expecting. And so we're clearing everybody off the course and trying to do that as safely and quickly as possible. And hopefully we'll have better weather tomorrow, and off we'll go.
All right, now people have chosen to keep on riding.
Yeah. What we do is some people, we cannot physically keep people from riding their bikes, so we take their numbers off and they give them to us, and we make sure they are aware that the course is closed and that they're riding at their own risk. Until they finish, and then they'll pick up their numbers for tomorrow, and we'll be back on track.
And the radio system has allowed you to do what?
The radio system has allowed us to coordinate. We have a lot of people like we do here at a church and throughout the route where we've pulled everybody off the route. The communication system has allowed us to coordinate buses, vans, and transport to get people back from these various locations on the course back to the home base.
And absolutely nobody's happy about this.
Nobody's happy about this.
You know, we can control a lot of things, but we can't control this.
So you guys have chosen to hang out here until you get picked up?
That's it. We're going to hang out here until we get picked up. Rather be safe than sorry. That's right. Rather be safe than sorry.
And ride some more tomorrow.
We're going to ride 100 tomorrow.
Y'all have a great ride. Be safe out there. Thank you, guys.
miles in. Rider number 878, broken collarbone. 911 called. Moto 1 on scene. Jeff en route. Other police and another SAG is there.
Roger that.
Second emergency. North Carolina 55. Prior to rest stop 4. Rest stop 4, Ham is en route to get a ham on site. SAG 7 is en route. Abby is en route. As soon as we can get a solid location for, instructions were given to get there. Excess injury, life or limb. Call 911, then let us know what the heck's going on.
Roger that. Shannon's en route.
Hey, Bruce, unless you think we can do something else, I'd like to just let the logistics thing happen. Ad-libbing it, and it's a well-oiled machine, and just stand by to get the reports from the emergency.
Bill, do you think I can have about 2 minutes to give some directions to SAG?
Oh, yeah. In fact, I think the only thing that needs to be yapping on the net right now is SAG information from you.
Okay, SAG 2 should just be running that 30-mile loop back and forth.
Moto 1, go ahead.
Roger, they got this fellow loaded up there, taking him down to Craven County. Is that a roger?
Roger that. I copy Craven County.
Roger, net control. Motor 1, clear.
So what happened?
I arrived on the scene after the accident occurred, but apparently the guy took a dump and he thinks he did something to his collarbone or something to that effect, to the point where he couldn't ride the bike.
Okay. Yeah. So you called 911?
Yes, sir.
And they got here and...
Called 911, they got here. It was handled very well. Everybody handled their job well.
I'm Rick, N4VQT. And, Rick Yost.
And to my way of thinking, you have the best duty of the event.
Yes, I do.
What do you do?
Oh, the best. I ride that motorcycle right there, and I basically check to see, make sure the bicyclists are okay out there on the road.
So you don't have to pick up anybody?
Negative. No, I do have to bandage a few people up every now and then, but that's about it. I don't pick anybody up and sag them.
Otherwise, you're just riding slowly on country roads.
That's exactly right.
And talking on a radio.
Mm-hmm.
You got your bike equipped for ham radio?
Yes, I do. Would you like to look at it?
Sure.
We got a Yaesu radio on here, an FT8800, and this radio is a dual bander, of course. Runs 2 meters, 70 centimeters. The radio is actually mounted in a saddlebag here on the back of the bike, and on the back of the bike over here, I have a Diamond NR770 antenna that I run, which is really good. It's kind of like a half-wave capacitive coupled, so I don't need much of a ground plane with that antenna, and it seems to work pretty good up here in the boondocks, if you will.
How do you talk and listen?
Well, in my helmet, I have a microphone inserted in the helmet here, and I've got the speakers inside the helmet.
And it works well? You can talk as you're riding down the road?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, just like I'm talking to somebody on the back of the bike. I have a push-to-talk right here on the side of the bike here. And just something comes up, I just call it in.
As I'm driving along, of course, in the car, I get stuck behind bikes. It can be hard to pass. You don't have any problem like that.
Negative.
Zip on by.
Zip right by, or I blend in with them very nicely, so without causing too much of a commotion. It works real well.
This is SAG 1. This is Kevin and N-U-A-T-Y, Bruce.
Oh, please, N-A-U-T-Y.
I'm sorry, N-A-U-T-Y.
So you guys direct all the SAGs?
Well, we at least tell them what we'd like for them to do, but some of them seem to be independent-minded.
Yes, sir. I'm at rest stop number 2 waiting further orders. You want me to head to rest stop 1 or continue on to rest stop 3?
It's the busiest job in the event, it would appear.
It is very busy. Many times we're on the cell phone, on the radio, talking to cyclists all simultaneously while driving.
How long have you been doing this?
This is my 20th year. Bruce?
15.
You ought to be better at it by now.
Well, there's just more ways to communicate with me now than there used to be.
Oh, you forgot texting.
Oh, yeah, texting, too. We're texting as well.
Exactly.
The event is getting bigger and bigger, more and more bikes.
That's right.
The number of hams you've got to work with seems to be getting smaller and smaller.
That's right. We could always use more hams. Yeah, in fact, we could definitely use more hams, yes.
Now, you've been talking about having more and more communications channels available.
Yes.
What does ham radio give you? Why don't you just use cell phones and texting?
Well,
and Facebook.
Facebook, I hope we're able to stay off of that for a while, but there's many areas that are quite remote here on the route that normal communications such as texting and cell phones just do not work, and without the ham radios, there's no way we could cover this course.
The other thing is that having the information on a network, a lot of times another station will hear the conversation and have pertinent information. If we were on cell phones, they wouldn't hear that conversation. And that saves a lot of time and often makes a crucial difference.
In the town of Oriental, along First Avenue,
I'm Dan Sears from Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
And you seem to be particularly well equipped here.
Well, we built the thing especially for these events because that's what the wife and I like to do. And it seems to come in handy and it gets the information back.
So what have you got? What did you put together?
We put together a 5x10 foot trailer, and we've got a UHF rig in there and VHF rig, and a generator to run it, and that's about it.
So relatively simple.
Yeah, absolutely simple, because the simpler the better, less things to go wrong.
But it provides you shade and shelter if it rains.
That's correct.
And what else?
And a place for people to gather.
It's a social event.
Well, sort of a social event, but you know, the hams can come here. There's a central point for information. It's pretty visible. Everybody knows where it is. The doctor is hanging out around here. He can monitor the frequencies and hear what's going on here, hear if his services are needed. The other hams, we've done some medical things at the beach to battleship last year. We were just overwhelmed with hypothermia cases, which we weren't expecting at all. And I was able to, you know, heat the trailer up and pack some people in it and warm them up. So it was acted as a shelter not only for us, but also for the riders. I try to be as ready as I can, and I feel by doing these, I have a greater degree of confidence that I am ready. This generator runs. I know that this generator is going to start on the first pull because we use it all the time out here.
Not just once a year at field day.
Not just once a year at field day, no.
Like mine.
But we use it every weekend. Do I really need the generator out here? Maybe not. But that's part of the deal, is to exercise it, keep it running, and that way I'm confident that it'll start.
Okay, so maybe somebody doesn't want to get into it quite as deep as you or me. What can they do? There's still a place for them?
Absolutely, there's a place for everybody. We needed some extra hams here, and they don't need to ride around in the car. They don't need to make a huge investment. A mobile radio, a simple antenna, that'll get them going. If they don't want to spend the money on gasoline, I understand that's expensive. Times are tough, but you can come and man a rest stop. You can volunteer at the start-finish line. You can run a SAG. There are lots of opportunities to do this and exercise your gear. You'll become a better operator. You absolutely will.
And when the chips are down, you won't be deer in the headlights. You'll have an idea what to do.
Absolutely. You've done it before, or at least you've done something similar. And not only that, there's one other benefit. By coming down here, by going to Wilmington, by going to Raleigh, by going to Chapel Hill, you get to work with different operators. You work with different clubs. You work with different people. Everybody has their own style. This net control here has a different style from, say, John Snelling or the folks in Raleigh. They do it differently. But if we have a big one, and I hate to keep going back to that, but let's hypothetically say we have a big one. Who knows who's going to be called in from across the state, and you're going to be answering the radio. Who knows who's going to be running net control?
How did you learn how to do what you do?
Coming out and doing it. That's it. Being stupid the first time, being stupid the second time, but less stupid. And some people will argue I'm still stupid, and that's okay.
welcome to the new and probably permanent homepage video here at hamsexy.com. It's not often that we run into a whacker vehicle out here in the wild, but we've come across one. And meets all the criteria. And look at all those antennas. Got count eight antennas, and of course he's got his flashing light going. Well, it doesn't look very permanent, but he's probably always got it there, and he's got his signs, bike rack, great big antenna, and let's see what he's got for radio equipment. Windows open. Oh yeah. Yeah, this is a whacker. That's a pure police vehicle setup. That mount and all that stuff. All those radios. What self-respecting ham needs that many radios? He's probably got like six handy talkies on his belt. So, yep. It's a whacker vehicle extraordinaire. Let's see who that guy is. Maybe he's got a ham plate. Oh, he does. KN4AQ. And he'll be proud to occupy this prime position on the homepage of Ham Sexy. Oh, wait, I think I see him coming. Hold on, I gotta hide. Yeah, look at that. Got the vest and all the handy talkies. Whacker Supreme. All right, well, go check out the rest of hamsexy.com.